to the squirrels!
Now you settle the chance. Boss, so what about that?
What do you want?
To speak with the wounded prisoner.
No one's allowed.
I'm here on Commandant Lorito's orders.
I already cut a deal with you, but...
So get out of my way.
He won't tell you much. He's dying.
Shut your traps. Stop bloody moaning down there.
Look, Coffer's dozed off.
Wakey, wakey, Coffer. You'll fall asleep forever any day now.
They beat him bad. He's got at least a dozen fractures. I'll need your help.
What do I do?
The spell I'm going to use is painful. It could kill him if he thrashes around.
I'll use the Axie sign to calm him.
Perfect.
Look, Birdie's all wet. Hey, Birdie! You get wet just looking at me.
Get ready, Birdie. We'll be there to see you right after our watch.
It's no use.
You wish, Horson. I'm no traitor.
He's raving.
That gun? Where am I?
In Flotsam, on the prison barge.
The convict's barge? I'm done for.
How did Lorito's goons catch Yorvith's right-hand elf?
I was betrayed. How else?
There's a witcher in Yorvith's unit.
Like every Dwan, he turned out to be a bastard.
What happened?
He betrayed us. He said he had an offer for me. So we met, where roses of remembrance grow. I should have known.
Roses of remembrance?
Yes. Some of the last in the world. He thought that I'd betray my elven brother in order to control the unit. I refused. And there was a fight. I've never seen anything like it. No human can move that fast. It was a massacre. I was the first to be hit. Thus I survived. I would have bled to death had Lorido's men not found me. Letho will kill Yorvith, and all will be lost. So many dead, so much suffering, all for naught.
Letho, he's the Kingslayer?
Yes.
Why does the Dwan want Yorvith dead?
He used us, from the start. Our hatred, but he no longer needs Yorvith. Sees him as a thorn in his side, though I don't know what Letho wants.
We got what we came for.
What now?
Yorvith.
What if Yorvith already knows?
I've got an old saying all ready for him. My enemy's enemy is my friend.
Warn him, Gwynplaine. Yorvith fights, for that is what he does best. He's Enshay, a real one, a free one. Among the last. Fighting makes sense, now more than ever before. There is still hope.
What are you talking about, Kieran? Hope for what?
For change. For a better tomorrow. I'll not see it. They'll torment me to death on this barge, and I'll go gladly where the apple trees bloom. But you must warn Yorvith.
Yennefer told me that Ciri has departed for good. She inhabits another world and is happy there. Before she left this one, she gave us the Isle of Avaloch, our island. We stopped counting time. People believe that the wraiths of the Wild Hunt are immortal. They race across the heavens, gripping in their bony hands swords, their lightning bolts. They take away mortals, ever expanding their cavalcade of spectral riders. They burned the orchard and the house. In their armored boots, they trampled our island. And then made off with Yennefer, I had to get her back. Return to reality. Return to the Witcher's path.
Geralt, are you all right?
I've been to the Isle of Avalach, among the apple trees and the mists. After the massacre in Rivia, Ciri took me there, and Yennefer. The Wraith Riders kidnapped Yen, and I pursued them.
But...
Triss, this is important. I feel like everything's coming together. When the Witchers found me barely alive a half year ago near Kaer Morhen, I was fleeing the Wraiths of the Hunt. They continued to pursue me, in the outskirts. Then in Vizima, when I killed the Grand Master. Now I know it was no coincidence.
Kieran mentioned roses of remembrance, growing somewhere near here. Cedric claims likewise. If that's true...
Right now, I should be searching the forest for Yorveth, not looking for flowers.
I could restore your memory.
You sure?
Everything seems to indicate that. Whatever's blocking your memory is clearly weakening. I think I could break that barrier with just one petal from a rose of remembrance. Those flowers are truly powerful.
In that case, Yorveth can wait.
Want me to go with you?
I'd love your company.
All right, then. Let's go. Cedric mentioned there are some old elven buildings near the cascade in the forest. We should start there.
Lead the way.
Shut your traps! Stop bloody moaning down there!
Look. Coffers dozed off.
Wakey wake. Fall asleep forever.
So, what about that bonus?
Is the work complete?
Not yet.
I think we've arrived. The cascade, the menhir. We need to take the path leading upwards.
Gardens in the middle of forests? Those elves really like to complicate things.
Stop whining. It's not far now. Cedric told me a beautiful legend about this place.
Legends are almost always beautiful, especially elven ones. The reality often leaves a lot to be desired.
Well, Cedric also said the site itself was something wonderful. The rose must be here somewhere.
I'll look around.
Alden and Cymoril. Cedric said Cymoril eclipsed even Francesca Findebear with her beauty, and Francesca's reputed to be the world's most beautiful woman.
Cedric drinks too much.
He really has visions, you know. He really has the gift. He could learn to control it if he drank less.
Cedric drinks to get rid of the visions, and that's something I understand perfectly well.
Oh my, lovers. Look out, it's beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
I just don't understand it. How did the elves become so cruel? The one with the scar had so much hatred in him.
Places like this make you realize just how much they've lost. There used to be entire elven cities, and the forests were theirs to enjoy, not to hide in.
Humans destroyed that, put them in reservations. Yorvith and his kind are taking revenge, though not all elves are like that.
Kieran said there's a lot more at stake.
He has his ideal, a certain vision of the world. But do you think there's room for humans in it?
We're practically one and the same.
Wrong, Triss. We've been learning from each other for generations, but we're different at base.
I don't know why I find that awfully sad.
Just like this garden. Beautiful and sad. Triss.
Slimerl's Rose of Remembrance. Legend has it they wilt unless nourished with blood, and also if they're sold. But give it to someone you love, and it'll live forever.
This one's for you.
Oh, Geralt.
I want you to keep it. If there's any truth to the legend, it shouldn't wilt, even if you pluck a petal or two.
Thank you.
This is the statue, Curly. Don't mind us. Imagine the corn we'll get. I won't leave the brothel for a month.
6 weeks, even.
Where does that woman get the gold for all this? I mean, her and the old man, they're buying a new house. And now these statues for the garden. Must be defrauding the treasury. What's a town chancellor do anyway?
It'd be ploughing hard to move.
We'd never shift it in one piece. I know. We'll break off the legs, the heads, remove it in bits.
Break off your own head, clown.
Shut your trap, cunt.
Anne!
Yeah! Kill them!
Watch out!
Oh.
Oh.
Incredible what the Enshade built before human ships ever appeared in the Pontar Delta. Elves possess a sensitivity humans can't ever hope to acquire.
We're trapped.
Looks like we're stuck. Well, there must be another way out of here. Why are you looking at me that way? Do I have something on my face? What's going on in that head of yours, Witcher?
Oh, you know. Stuff. You could use a bath.
So could you.
a witch's blade. Letho comes here to think.
Well, he's not here now, so we've no reason to stay.
The Dwan stole the story of Eldin and Symeril, but they now steal our roses of remembrance. A more silly and shallow tale I've never heard. An enchanted wood, a beautiful elven couple living within. A handsome human prince arrives, riding a milk-white stallion. Bloody Dwan. We Enshe remember how it was. Limitless devotion, passion, commitment, and sacrifice. Legend has it the lovers' sighs are enchanted within these very stones, though only those in love can hear them.
Singing bushes, jabbering stones, elven hogwash. Well, I'm buggered.
We should take walks more often. For a while there, I forgot all about Flotsam, the Scoia'tael, the Kingslayer, the whole world, really.
Nice to know I still have that power.
I need time to devise the spell. It could take as much as a few days.
Mm-hmm.
What do you plan to do while you wait?
I'm going to meet Yorvith.
Well, don't get yourself killed. That'd be pretty stupid now.
What are you getting at?
You're about to recover your memory, which will give you a whole new perspective on things. We'll learn what happened to Yennefer.
Uh-huh. And you expect me to drop everything and tell Roach, hey, it's been great, but I've got places to go and people to find?
You know, you could. I mean, you don't really owe him anything. I'm just afraid you'll get caught up in something and you won't be able to back out. Yorvath's a sly old elf. He's been fighting humans for a full century at least. This Letho is no common bandit either, and I shudder to think who put him on the warpath. It's a mire, Geralt. Deep and hungry, and it could swallow you whole before you know it.
It possibly already has.
I want you to know that I'm prepared to travel to the end of the world with you to save Yennefer. I owe you that. I owe her that. I'm prepared to drop everything. The trappings of court life, politics, the regicides. I could even live at Kaer Morhen. It's up to you.
Triss.
Let me finish. I can only say this once. If you want to go alone, I'll understand. And I won't try to persuade you otherwise.
I can't know what the future holds. I don't know what else is hidden in my mind. But whatever it is, whatever happens, I don't want to lose you. I'd have to be an utter fool and complete ingrate to let you go.
That's kind. Thank you. Does that mean we're leaving the regicides to Roach and tending to our own matters?
I think so, and I think you're right. I don't owe anyone anything.
I'm glad you've noticed that.
But that doesn't mean I'm willing to sit around doing nothing. You need time anyway, and in that time I'll catch the Kingslayer.
Geralt, please, be careful.
I'll go see Zoltan, and together we'll go find Yorvith. With a little luck, I'll capture the Kingslayer, and then we can go back to living our own lives.
Good. Will you talk to Roach?
I'll think about it.
Geralt! Geralt! There you are. Is everything all right?
This is nice. What a beautiful place.
Very.
How'd you find us?
Finding those I seek is a speciality of mine. Now, let's get out of here. The Scoia'tael are out in droves.
Wait, Vernon. We need to talk.
About what?
A few days from now, I plan to leave, get back on the path, back to my witcher's work. That'll mean the end of our mission.
Care to tell me what prompted this decision?
Triss. She knows how to restore my memory.
Why not drop everything and leave now?
Triss needs time to prepare the spells.
You're giving up. No other name for it. You're just giving up. What of the Kingslayer? Many still believe you're him.
I don't think I care anymore. Those whose opinions I value, well, they know the truth.
Uh-huh. You see someone kick a dog, and you're incapable of letting it go. And you want to release that fiend who we've succeeded in cornering, who's thrashing to get out of the cage we've put up around him.
I want nothing of the sort. I'm not leaving for a few more days. In that time, I'll catch Letho for you. That's the Kingslayer's name, incidentally. I know how to get him.
How?
You're not going to like this, but it'll involve working with the Scoia'tael.
Is your mind completely plowed at this point? Did Triss put this nonsense in your head?
Listen to me. You'll get your Kingslayer soon. I'll give you him or his head. After which you'll clear me of all charges and let me go my way.
What else? Perhaps you'd like me to embrace Yorveth in gratitude as well.
Yorveth's not my problem. I'm no elf hunter. I've never been one, and I don't intend to become one.
Oh, enough. You've made your decision, I can see that. So be it. But I think we all know who's being the prick here.